evolution, the driving force behind the building blocks of all manner of matter and the living, breathing, endless torrent of life finding its way amongst the cosmos. The truth of the matter is, evolution is a wonderfully unpredictable thing. It is relentless in its endless pursuit to propagate life. And ever since our distant amphibious ancestors crawled out of the primordial soup, our species of Homo sapien were the eventual victors of the hard-fought millennia-long battle towards sentience. Thankfully, we could stand on two legs, run really fast, make friends, and start a fire. The many benchmarks that our planet requires to kickstart a civilization. But unfortunately for us, in this hypothetical situation, we've just been swatted away by the unfathomable will of the universe. Goodbye, I guess. But either way, forget about that. Who's next? Let's find out. Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, if humans went extinct, what would replace us? Roll the clip. For the curious amongst you, that clip was, of course, from the resounding 2011 movie Rise of the Planet of the Apes, where Caesar finally found his voice and told humanity that their time had come over here on planet Earth. Which, of course, probably leads us to our first and most important opening point. Obviously, the likeliest candidate to be the animal that replaced our species following a mass extinction event would be our closest relatives, and it doesn't really take that much imagination to perhaps envision a world similar to the planet of the Apes series, where unless you're an unfortunate time-traveling human astronaut caught in a wormhole, there shouldn't be any concern for being rounded up, captured, and put in a cage by our new ape overlords, given the fact that, well, we'd already be dead. The fact of the matter is, humankind is the only current living hominid whose conservation status is not already endangered, or worse than that, critically endangered. Across the planet, the animal kingdom is under imminent threat from the ever-expanding megalith of human civilization, and the delicate environs and ecospheres that the likeliest contenders to inherit the Earth currently residing are under increasing amounts of pressure. In all likelihood, the kind of global crisis that would precede a mass extinction event of humanity would also wipe out pretty much every species on the planet, apes included. In fact, our bonobo and chimpanzee contenders would be just as likely to contract a population-destroying disease as we humans would be. However, that doesn't mean that there aren't many other choice contenders to perhaps take the next top spot for planet Earth's most dominant species. Obviously, for the sake of this hypothetical argument, we'll agree that there was no apocalyptic event that heralded our demise, and humanity just kind of disappeared overnight, not with a bang, but a whimper. Because then that leaves us with so many more options, and as they say, variety is the spice of life. But first, we'll have to map out just exactly what it may take to clamber to the top of the evolutionary pile and detail the specific earthly requirements that precede it. If we use our own evolutionary track record, we know that there are roughly 3 or 4 key elements for a species to make its way towards some form of sentient success on Earth. The main one being that they need to have a long enough lifespan to see the fruit of their labor grow. That means don't worry about the creatures of the deep ocean crawling from the depths and taking over, because did you know the average lifespan of an octopus is between 3 to 5 years? And on the path towards sentience and civilization, that's a pretty bum deal. First off, there needs to be some kind of capacity for sociability. Our ancestors quickly learned that being the loner of the group didn't tend to result in any kind of continued survival. Particularly in the latter stages of our pursuit toward humanity, the ability to socially interact with other members of our species led toward a sense of shared cooperation, and with cooperation came success. Social cues and some form of expression recognition led to tools, hunting, gathering, and eventually agriculture and the dawn of civilization. That means that particularly here, pack animals such as canines and some felines and other species such as otters and beavers have an immediate advantage. Obviously, apes are also included on this list, but come on, those guys are already cheating. Next up, the ability for physical manipulation is of critical importance. The sociable path toward toolmaking and farming is worthless if you don't have the appendages to contribute toward force multiplication. Dexterity and motor skills are an absolute must for any current species that hopes to fill the space left behind by humanity. And again, apes already have this market pretty much cornered. However, traditional hands and fingers aren't the only requirement, as theoretically any form of extended appendage can do the trick. An elephant's trunk, even an octopus tentacle, would work. The most likely candidates here, though, other than the apes, are those with some form of opposable thumb. This could be anything from an opossum, a koala bear, a giant panda, a red panda, or hell, even most types of frog. Also, otters again fit into this category, and our cute hand-holding friends are quickly becoming the hot new favourite. Speaking of hot, there's perhaps another major leap that our new earthly tenants would need, and unless they've got a Perseus of their own to steal fire from the gods, the ability to strike a flint and tinder is a checkbox that needs to be ticked. You see, unless the chemical composition of our planet changed during the events of this hypothetical situation, somewhere down the line, our new species is going to have to learn how to make a campfire, and that pretty much eliminates any aquatic or semi-aquatic species unless they're in the business of figuring out some other method of physical combustion. Again, this is where the apes are cornering the market, as there are already instances where bonobos can light fires with ease, albeit with butane lighters, and then fry an egg for dinner. Yeah, like I said, guys, they're pretty overpowered. The fact of the matter is, if we disappeared tomorrow, our ape relatives are probably a few thousand years away from reaching a similar journey toward levels of sentience, if left enough alone. Although the particular mechanics of that are the subject matter for a future LBQ video. Spoilers. Because of that fact, pretty much all of the other contenders wouldn't have the chance to hit the parameters needed to build a civilization, and our answer quickly reaches a matter of reality. However, there is one hypothetical instance where a much, much smaller creature than an ape would perhaps find their way through the minefield that is evolutionary success, given enough time, of course. After the dinosaurs were wiped out, the small shrew-like rodent that previously skittered beneath the feet of the great reptilian creatures became the first mammal to step forward in a new age of evolution, eventually giving rise to every other successful land mammal of the animal kingdom. And if we put ourselves in the shoes of dinosaurs, what would we see when we look down? Ants. A species of insect belonging to the order Hymenoptera that just so happened to tick quite a few of our boxes when it comes to evolutionary success, that also seem to exhibit fascinating traits that segue many of the parameters required to become a dominant species here on Earth. Obviously, ants are small, very, very small, but just like that tiny shrew, evolution has a pretty successful habit of finding a way. Maybe after humanity is long, long gone, even after our nearest mammalian relatives gave civilization a shot, after several millennia of strange, perplexing epochs, a species that evolved from their distant ancestor, the ant, would be sat at their desk, clicking their thorax, spindled fingers against a keyboard, trying to answer this very same question. Now, that's quite a thought, isn't it? Well, there we have it, our very long and very short answer to the question, if humans went extinct, what would replace us? In all likelihood, it would be apes, although ants have a pretty decent shot given a long enough time. What do you guys think? Do you agree, disagree, or do you see it some other way entirely? Let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, as well as any choice picks of your own. Before we depart from today's video, let's first take a quick look at some of your more creative comments from over the past few days. King Bong Hogger says, looks like Rebecca finally let Jack Finch out of the basement to do a video. Yay. Sorry? What? Yeah, okay. I'm literally here every other day though, dude, so I'm not sure what videos you've been watching. Or am I? Whoa, weird. Anyway, on that note, unfortunately, that's what we've got time for in today's video. Just stick around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video or just life's biggest questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button as well as that subscribe bell, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.